And we're going to be talking to Brad, the guy who made the damn game.
What's up?
How's it going, man?
It's going good.
Thank you for hanging out with us. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem.
So we're going to play your pretty awesome game, Wrack, here.
So is this live now, or are you not
Yeah,
streaming?
we're streaming okay. Right now.
Cool.
Awesome. Go to twitch.tv/reviewlabs. If you throw out tweets, I'm sure these kind people that are in the call with us will throw some retweets. We're joined by my friend AJ, who's just here because he happens to know me, and he likes abusing me on stream. And then we're joined by Eric, who does a pretty amazing podcast.
Hi.
Awesome.
And
hey, what's up?
Then there's my dumbass, so...
And my dumbass is now here, so...
Go
so, ahead. Yeah, awesome.
I'm going to start on the main campaign on Medium.
Sure. Is it possible for you to, like, share your screen with me? Because, like, if I watch through the stream, it'll be lagged. I don't know. That's probably fine.
I think... yeah, because if I do screen sharing through Skype, it might conflict with OBS.
Okay. All right. Yeah. No problem.
Okay. So, if you want to kind of take us through... Wherever you want to start, man, like, tell us about this game. Tell us why it's dope. Tell us where you came up with the idea for stuff. Tell us what Skittles are better, sour or tropical.
Are Skittles better than...
Which Skittles are better, sour or tropical?
Oh, you know, I'm not a big Skittles eater, but, tropical sounds better,
doesn't it?
who wants sour candy?
You don't like sour candy?
I mean, you think fruit. I mean, you think, you know, juicy and sweet. You don't think sour. I don't think.
Yeah, if you want sour, go eat a lemon.
That's right.
Get out of here with that.
Like a pina colada bag of Skittles.
That sounds interesting. You know, they have so many crazy flavors for things now. I'm sure they have that.
That sounds great. Like, really, I would really dig that. But there's probably a Jelly Belly that's pina colada.
Oh, boy.
I don't like things
I could almost, like, picture it. Like, I've seen it before, but I don't know, maybe not.
Well, they have Jelly Bellies for spaghetti and grass, so I'm pretty sure there's a pina colada one.
Spaghetti and grass?
Yeah. Do you remember the...
That doesn't even make sense.
No, sounds like me in college.
There was Harry Potter special edition Jelly Bellies for the Harry Potter movies, obviously, and they had, like, dirt and spaghetti and grass and, like, all these horrid flavors.
Like, where does that idea come from? Like, you spill, like, some spaghetti on the ground outside, you're like, you know what, that would make a great flavor for a candy. Like, what? That's ridiculous.
That seems a little absurd, doesn't it?
Oh, here we go. Also, earwax and boogers.
The earwax-flavored jelly beans were a thing in the Harry Potter books.
Oh.
Vomit?
Gotten earwax in their mouth and was like, you know what, that's tasty. I'd like to consume this on a regular basis in product form. But no, like, who thinks that?
Well, I mean, like...
J.K. Rowling, apparently.
There's a vomit-flavored one. Like, who's like, you know what I really need more of in my life? The taste of vomit in my mouth.
That's obviously for the alcoholic who just can't get enough.
No, the alcoholic is not addicted to alcohol, is just addicted to vomiting.
Yeah, he's just
eat a bunch of pina colada flavored ones and then follow it up with some vomit flavored ones, and it's like, you know, being in a frat.
And that out on the town.
Awesome.
Oh, I'm so dumb. Okay, here we go. I'm like half paying attention to what I'm doing on here because I'm thinking about pina colada vomit Skittles and jelly beans.
That actually makes sense when you mentioned, like, it came from the Harry Potter universe, because, like, she just put it in there as, like, oh, this is funny, this is goofy. And then, of course, someone takes the books way too seriously and wants to make it into, like, an actual physical product.
The sad thing is that there's, like, consumers out there that would totally buy into that, you know?
Yeah, when Dumbledore gets the earwax flavored anything flavor bean, it's a joke, and I don't know. I certainly didn't, when reading that book, say, I'd like to try that.
Yeah. But yeah, that's a lot more plausible than, you know, sitting down in a marketing meeting like, you know what, guys, here's my billion-dollar idea. Let's do grass-flavored spaghetti. I mean, you'd be laughed out of the room. But
you know what, man? I think the Whole Foods crowd would eat that up.
I think maybe that's true.
As long as you say, like, it has, like, amazing health benefits, like, it prevents 1% lower chance of cancer, you know, like, those people eat it up.
Oh, yeah.
You know, here's something about the Whole Foods crowd that bothers me. If you have a strong opinion on raw milk, either way, I don't want to hear it. You're an asshole.
Oh, Steve, you just got lava'd, son.
I did.
Damn, after you beat that boss and everything, you were looking like a badass and you jump in lava?
I know. That's how it rolls sometimes. You think you're doing well in life, you get a nice girlfriend, you get a nice place, everybody thinks you're cool, everyone knows your name at loft parties, and sometimes people try to give you drugs for free, and you're like, nah, man, I don't do that, but thanks. And then, just out of nowhere, you fall into some lava, and you're
just
like, lava, well, that
just comes out of nowhere.
You know, this game is a very accurate, and not even metaphor, like, this is exactly what life is like. I mean,
no,
what
it
you
is.
Just said, I mean, that happens on a daily basis.
It and, does.
You know, I'm just walking home yesterday, and lava. I mistimed my 20-foot jump, and, you know, lava.
Of course, man.
That's called magma when it's
You know, that's why the lava is in this game. It's to prepare you for real life when you have to jump across a lava pit.
That's how my dad went, getting the mail. And that was it.
Just surprised lava out of the mailbox. It just started spilling everywhere.
No, there was a 20-foot lava trap that he had to jump over every day to get the mail. Like, okay. You know, like you do. And, you know, he just mistimed his jump that day and he didn't have an extra life. That was it.
See, you know, had he played Wrack on a daily basis, he would have been able to make that jump from all the practicing.
That's true.
You know, and they say video games aren't useful. See, I disagree.
Yeah, stuck it, Dad. You'd still
you're,
be
you're
alive.
You're wasting your time. Yeah, well, we'll see who can jump that lava pit when you know,
need to get the fucking mail.
Swallow us all.
You know, me and my friends used to play, like, Minecraft versus. Like, we would set up our own bases and try to kill each other. And what I would always do is I would get a bucket of lava, and I would get down to, like, where they were mining, and I would mine in from the top and pour my bucket of lava on them. That's how I
amazing.
Always won.
You are the best friend.
It was good. It was
like,
fun.
In any game, like, just lava is just, it's the best. Like, you don't mess with lava.
Yeah, you don't fuck around with lava, man.
That's right, yeah. Like green slime you can fuck with, but lava...
I don't know, man. The green barrels in Doom are nothing to fuck with.
That's
true. Speaking of green barrels in Doom, you're about to get to the next level, which may have those.
May have barrels.
Yeah.
So, where do you think...
They do, otherwise why would I have said that?
They don't. There's, like, no green barrels in the game at all.
Yeah, I'm just like...
Just, like...
making shit up.
Like, counter-hyping.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of Minecraft, wait till you get to the next level.
I need to make sure that archiving is turned on for this. Hold on 1 second. I'm gonna... Because I don't want to lose this stream. This is a good one. It's... where do you think the future is headed if we don't invent those barrels full of explosive chemical materials pretty soon?
See, well, we're just going to have trouble blowing things. Like, I mean, how are you supposed to blow things up if you don't have a barrel with toxic goo in it?
Yeah.
That's yeah. To me, that just seems like the default way to blow something up.
Right.
Yeah, and how are enemies supposed to design their bases if they
right.
don't?
Yeah. And how are you supposed to kill enemies if you don't have them all grouped around barrels? Like,
there has to be someone who goes in and puts the barrels in like ahead of time, and that's got to be like the shittiest job in the universe.
Just like some barrel contractor. Says,
okay, all you little dudes with no health, you stand right here, right next to this thing. Because that's strategically where you should be located, next to the exploding barrel, which will rip you to shreds.
Okay, cool. We've got it. I just got to save the casts, so we're good on that front. Let me get some tweets out there while we're taking a quick buzz.
Yeah, I just tweeted it out to...
Let me check my Twitter.
On both mine and the Wrack account, so...
Cool. I am going to do some retweets then.
Sweet.
And where's... Retweeted.
Retweeted. Yeah, I got you.
Cool. Thank you, AJ.
Yeah, dog. I'm always up on this Twitter shit. Hey, is my mic better now, chat? Somebody was telling me to turn it up like 20 minutes ago.
You sound good to me. You sound rich and melodious.
Hey, like, while you're tweaking the settings, is it possible to, like, change the game you're playing to Wrack instead of Shadow of Mordor?
I totally just updated that, so if you
refresh.
Yeah, I noticed that as well.
Still says Pixel Fireplace in my browser.
Oh, you have to F5 that shit.
Yeah, F5 at home skillet.
I guess I will do that right now.
F5.
I was thinking I was going to interrupt the stream, but I got it muted so I can, so I'm not hearing you guys on a delay. So yeah, cool. There we go.
Yeah, it should be all fixy fixed. Is it for everybody?
It is. Yeah.
Sweet. Now we can get back to murdering things with the barrels that may or may not be in the next level. Okay, and close out the browser if there's anything people are saying in chat that's important.
But see, I mean, maybe there aren't barrels there. Like, that's how I keep you on the edge. Like, being like, oh, maybe. See, I don't know. He could be lying. He could be telling the truth. I don't know. I'll just have to wait and see.
People just start going insane. Like, where are the barrels?
You gotta build suspense for barrels, dude. That's the problem with Donkey Kong. You just got the barrels right away.
That's true.
Yeah, yeah, right.
That's bullshit. That's why that game is such bullshit.
I mean, yeah, it should have been Donkey Kong tumbling down the thing, and then, like, the barrel was the final boss.
Like, yes. The barrel had kidnapped Princess Peach or whoever the fuck it was in that game.
Yeah. I mean, it makes more sense. I mean, the barrel's more... the barrel can explode. Donkey Kong can't explode. Like, he's not threatening. That's what's dangerous.
Or it's like Earthworm Jim.
You have never tried playing Donkey Kong with grenades.
Yeah.
It's like Earthworm Jim at the end where he just unzips himself and he's a barrel underneath the gorilla suit.
Samus was actually a barrel all along, just nobody's gotten the good enough ending.
I think she might be a barrel. Like, that's how she gets all, like, in her little ball form and rolls around. Like, she's just a barrel, but, like, you see it from the side, so you think it's a sphere. No, it's a barrel.
So, maybe the suit is actually made out of barrels.
That's a possibility.
Oh, what's up, Remy Punks?
There were barrels, and I blew them up. And it turns out that when you blow them up with a sword when you're standing next to him, you die.
Yeah, that's...
that sword is badass, by the way.
It is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, thanks. Like, we wanted there to be, like, actual... By the way, I don't know why that's happening, the camera clipping through the ground. I'm going to have to look into that. But,
It's also because my computer kind of sucks, so...
No, it's not that. Like, it seems like there is, like, weird situations where it happens, and trying to look into it. But,
I may have to turn shadows off so we can get a better frame rate because my shit blows. And turn some filtering down. Sorry, guys.
There's someone in chat with the handle GG Marshmallow.
That's amazing. Aw, man, I ate the lava again.
His name is GG Marshmallow, and he says, "What are you toasty gentlemen playing today?" I see what you did there. I see it.
Oh man, you didn't even try to.
See,
avoid
and you're
that
playing with a controller too. Like, on top of that, you know, it's on top of that, and your attention being, you know, diluted by the stream and the slowdown and everything. Yeah, so that's.
Yeah, I understand.
if you're having a tough time.
I'm doing my best there.
Yes, I put in FOV settings because of Total Biscuit. Yes, I did put them in like the night the video went up because of it.
I'm not entirely sure what that means.
Oh, well, Total Biscuit did a video of this game like 2 years ago, and it's funny. He started off in the beginning of the video like, "Oh, you know, this game has every option you could ever want," and then like by the end of it, he's like, "Where's the FOV slider?" You know, just. he goes from like completely satisfied to like complaining about lack of FOV slider like by the end of the video over the course of a 10-minute video, and I don't know, people like to make a big deal out of the FOV thing, so it's there.
I think I could.
I give the people what they want, and by the people I mean Total Biscuit.
I could have done a much better job with that kill chain back there, but I suck, so I didn't.
That's okay. It's it's pretty hard on a controller. Like if we end up porting it to consoles, and I think we will eventually. And I'm gonna have to really think about what I'm gonna do to make the game, kind of tweak it, kind of tailor it to consoles and all that. Because I mean, it just like with a controller, like you fundamentally can't aim as well as you can with a mouse.
True. You know, the funny thing about that too is I actually played Titanfall on PC, and I play with a controller, and I managed to kick a lot of ass on there.
Do you know why that is?
Why?
If you play with a controller, you automatically have auto aim.
That's not true. I disable it.
No, it gives you auto aim for the controller with Titanfall, as far as I've read.
Thanks for taking the wind out of my sails.
I
thought that I was overcoming a deficiency, and you're like, nah.
No, you get auto aim.
The game is just helping you suck less.
There's an aim lock button in this, too. It's the left shoulder. So.
That's cool.
Yeah, so it's like once your crosshair goes over an enemy, it's like you'll lock onto it. But by the way, you probably don't want to use the sword at all times.
But
Steve,
it's fun.
Steve, you're as bad as first person.
It is fun, but most of the weapons are like situational. Oh, I think it's start on the controller.
So. Oh, I get it. I get how to do the lock, dude. This changes everything.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. That's it.
Sweet.
Yeah, it's really good against those sentries, those little flying orb things.
Yeah, totally. Those things suck. I don't like
them.
Take them out of the game, and anything else that can hurt me probably would be
good. So no barrels, no lava, no...
Yeah, that's just
console.
Just have
a nice leisurely stroll.
The console version, yeah.
Exactly. Just Proteus, but with, these graphics.
That'd be awesome.
And Marshmallow, it's on Steam now. It just came out yesterday, officially.
Are you going to send it back to Total Biscuit?
We're trying to get him to look at it again. We're in contact with his rep, so hopefully, our fingers are crossed. Hopefully that happens.
For sure.
Yeah, that would be really cool.
Well, I mean, this kind of seems like his type of thing. Like, he always talks about how he loves the old school shooters and shit like that.
Right.
And he made one, so I mean,
yeah. See, so, yeah, I mean, I kind of have the same opinion of him, except I'm a developer, and he's a big YouTube star, and big influential media member. So, hopefully he can kind of help. Kind of usher this genre back into some degree of prominence.
No, for sure, and I'm glad that he holds that position, because I definitely miss games like this. Like, me and Steve, 6 months ago, we went back and played through Doom 1 and Doom 2, mm-hmm. like, in their entirety, because those games are so fucking fantastic.
Yeah.
So, yeah, no, I totally agree. I'm glad that you made a game like this, for sure.
Yeah, it's... I actually got the kind of inkling to do this kind of thing, for a long time, probably the past 10 years or so, but, it didn't actually start developing it until 6 years ago. But, you know, it was kind of like a lot of the shooters that were coming out. It was like people just kind of went away from this genre and just kind of like went purely with the whole regenerating health kind of, you know, and slow movement kind of model, you know, kind of like a whole Halo kind of style of shooter.
Right.
And it, like, everyone just kind of like decided, okay, well, I guess that's what the market wants. You know, no one wants this other kind of shooter unless you just only make this kind of game. And, you know, that's, you know, like to me, that doesn't make any sense. Like, I still feel like this is a very solid genre. Like, it has, like, very good, solid core fundamentals that make it just fun to play and timeless and just awesome. It's like there's no reason like a game like this shouldn't be around today in 2014.
No, I totally agree, and I think you're really going to tap into like a nostalgia market whenever it comes to a game like this, for sure, because I know I've been aching for a new game that's less of a run in a straight line type of shooter.
Right.
You know, I mean, I miss my secrets and my collectibles and my non-regenerating health. So, yeah, good on you, man, for sure.
Yeah, it's like there's like a video. I mean, it's a couple of people have cited the study, but I what was the guy's name? Like a Howard Moskowitz, I think. He was like a taste test guy, or like a, you know, he's a guy who like helped companies like do research with their taste testing and everything, and I guess what he was trying to do is like he was trying to come up with like a universal like best pasta sauce that appealed to everyone.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And you know, he messed with all these different things. He basically found like you can't do it. Like you can't make one sauce that appeals to everyone. Like you need to have like fundamentally different kinds of pasta sauce. And you know, it's you know, so it's like you had to have regular, you had to have like spicy, and then there was like another kind that people were wanting, but like it wasn't even on the market at all. So you know, and that was like chunky. So it's basically, you know, kind of the idea is that, I mean, you need diversity, you need different kinds of games. You know, it's you can't have it's just one kind of shooter like isn't going to appeal to everyone, and. So it's like you kind of want there to be that variety, and that's kind of what we're trying to do in this. You know, I kind of feel like we're like the chunky pasta sauce of Wrack Chunky Edition.
That sounds like something that should happen.
Yeah. Oh,
and I get a free can of like mushroom marinara sauce with it.
Do you guys sell this game on your website DRM free?
There's like a login system, but you know, there's no, you know, you don't have to have Steam open or anything. And I mean, it's also on Desura, which is totally DRM free.
Okay.
But I haven't updated either of those yet.
Because, okay, like, cool.
Just Steam has just been.
Yeah, the only reason I ask is because people in chat were asking if they can buy it DRM free.
Guys, tweet out there that we're chatting with Brad from Wrack, and get other people in here to ask him some cool questions and why we don't get all the badass Twinkies that Japan does.
Oh my god, and they're Kit Kats, man?
Oh,
I
they're
was
Kit
gonna
Kats.
Say Kit Kats.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
And they're Whoppers with 7 patties?
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
The black hamburger was the big thing this past week, wasn't it?
Who sees that and is like, yeah, I want to put that burger that looks like it's made out of ash in my mouth. Like,
apparently, you know, the Japanese.
If watching Iron Chef taught me anything, it's that you can add squid ink to anything and people in Japan will eat it.
Is that what it's like?
That was the whole message of that show, essentially.
No, is that why that burger patty is black? Like,
yeah, it's squid ink.
Wow.
Interesting.
That's weird.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I'm going to stick to my regular wheat buns and...
You don't want a squid ink burger? Come on, man.
It's for Halloween, dude. It's a holiday they don't even really celebrate there.
That's like on Fear Factor, I wouldn't eat that.
all down for the bull testicles, but the squid ink burger, no thank you.
Yeah, that's my stance.
That's my stance, personally.
Like, whoa, I draw the line at black meat. That's...
Yeah. Well, the meat isn't black. Everything else is black, though.
Oh, that's... Oh, what? Like, black lettuce and tomatoes and shit?
It didn't appear to have any lettuce or tomatoes on it. It's like a black bun with black cheese and a black sauce.
Oh, black cheese.
Black cheese! Oh!
that's horrifying. That's even worse than the patty.
Weird.
Yeah.
Because I'm thinking about it, a charbroiled burger patty has some black scorch marks.
I wouldn't want to eat like a I see that and I'm like, that's like gonna give me cancer or something. That's
yeah.
Oh.
Like raptor cancer.
Yeah.
Water on a train. I don't know why I had such difficulty reading that. Can you jump? Yes, you can jump. It's actually encouraged in this game. There's a lot of little kind of optional like platforming challenges. Like for instance, it's gonna be 45 seconds ago, but what I'm watching is Steve fighting in a big room with a sentry spinning around and a couple pillars in the middle of a nice little lava room, and there's some treasures sitting on those pillars, and you can jump over there and get them. You don't have to, but
I totally went for it and died.
Yeah, Steve, you would be really great at this game if the objective was to jump into the lava.
Yeah, dude, I would be the master. Oh my god, I really suck.
What's kind of nice about the live system is that like once you get a piece of treasure, like you actually do the platforming challenge. You don't have to do it again. Like it stays in
your... Oh my god, why is lava such a bitch for me?
There was another guy who was screaming a couple nights ago, and like he was like in the lava constantly too, and some of the people in the tree were like, there he is in his natural habitat, the lava.
Maybe that's what it is. I'm
becoming
just, like,
one with the lava.
A tadpole that thrives on lava.
And I do want to stress that you are on a gamepad. It's definitely more difficult in that. Yeah. Partially because like this game has strafe running, where it's like if you strafe right and move forward at the same time, like you go faster, and that's pretty hard to do on a controller. So
yeah. I just love the speed of this game. Like, it's so fast.
Tuffles is wanting to see the option screen. I think he's Total Biscuit in disguise. There's definitely plenty of options, and I hope. I hope it's sufficient. Yeah, there's all sorts of... there have been some people who have had frame rate issues, and that's understandable. I mean, this is a game where there's hundreds of monsters on a level. There's tons of stuff going on. There's jibs everywhere, and so it's and the bodies stay around. So
yeah,
it's totally conceivable that you have to turn some settings down to compensate for that. Plus, if you're streaming, that doesn't help.
I love the art style in this game.
Yes, there's an FOV slider. Yes, there is.
Did you ever play 13 for PS2?
I have not played it. I'm definitely familiar with it. I actually see it on my shelf right now. But I never installed it, sadly. But yeah, that's... That's definitely a game that's kind of inspired this art style. I mean, we knew we wanted to do something different, something visually, kind of like something vibrant, colorful. It's kind of set it apart from the brown photorealistic
pictures. Like industrial corridor deluxe.
Right, right. Look at my sand with ridiculous amounts of tessellation and specular maps. It's just.
Right.
So,
I don't know what those words mean, and I'm not sure I want to.
I'm not sure I know what they mean. There is MSAA. There's FXAA. There's AF. There's Yeah, there's all sorts of settings, so you should be able to configure it to your liking. We wanted to do something, you know, kind of like visually different than that. The other thing is, like, I kind of feel like we're so used to, you know, we as humans, as people, like, we're so used to, like, what is real. Like, I mean, we're, you know, every second of the day, pretty much, that we're not staring at a video game screen, we're looking at something that's real. So, like, we know what things that are real look like. And I feel like if you try and simulate that, unless you get it, like, exactly 100% perfect, like, you're going to end up in Uncanny Valley. And it's so hard to overcome that. Like, I feel like even the games that have, like, just these crazy budgets, like, even they, you know, there's times where it's like an animation doesn't look right, or, you know, the mouth flaps don't sync up with you know, a character who's talking or something, you know, yada yada. And it looks jarring and wrong to me.
Yeah,
so, you know,
no,
I kind of feel like if you're not going for realistic, you know, you kind of get around that. You know, it's funny. It's like a this is how long this game has been in development. You know, that I'm kind of going to this is, you know, kind of my example for this. But the guy who did Terminator 3, he was like the director on that game, or not game, movie.
Mm-hmm.
But, like, rather than do, like, a lot of the robots and everything with, like, CGI, he wanted to do them with, like, puppets. So it's like it's an actual, like, real thing you're looking at, not like a simulation. And, you know, he just felt like he had a lot better results that way.
Yeah,
practical effects always look better in movies.
Yeah,
I am very much inclined to agree with that. That's why the final battle in Return of the King, Lord of the Rings, is really good. There's lots of miniatures and traditional effects like that. I'm running literally in a circle. Why am I saying
you gotta go in the
I see that, yeah,
the thing you're running around.
Switch. God, I'm done.
No, like, this is a game where, like, you have to really be aware of your surroundings and everything. And it also takes a lot of experience. And, you know, like, if you're on a stream and, you know, you're not 100% focused on the game, it's definitely gonna impact your
I should be the master of all, though.
I agree. I'm not disputing that.
Man, I'm disappointed with myself.
Did you die again?
No.
Oh, okay. Good.
I beat the level, I think. Or no, I didn't. I completed one of the sections of the level. There we go. I'm proud of myself.
Can I run it in 800 by 600 on Windows 98? I don't see why you would want to. It's like, can I run this game on a toaster?
Yeah.
Can I run this game on a 486? Yeah, I don't know.
On a 486, yeah. Easy Bake Oven.
Yes, yes.
Oh, that thing.
Tuffles is asking, what language was this made in? Unity with C. I assume you mean C sharp. It's actually a custom engine from scratch. Because I have no life. I was just watching you die to that, to the barrels, which I alluded to in the previous level. It's actually a custom engine from scratch, done in C++. I have not seen the sun in 6 years. I have not been outside. I have no life. That part is actually true. I haven't seen the sun. But yeah, it's been a lot of work to pull it off. But
Well, I mean, it shows, man. You've got a great-looking, great-playing game.
Well, thanks.
Yeah.
Yeah, I feel like by doing, you know, doing the intro from scratch, you really get the ability to just really have full control over what you're doing. So, like, you get the ability to just really do everything right. You know, it's like, I mean, you know, people like to compare this game to Borderlands, and that game actually doesn't do cell shading. Like, he just puts, like, an outline around everything, but, like, as far as, like, the actual shading on the models, like, it's not cell shading. Like, it's just shading with an outline. Like, whereas this, like, you can see, like, the actual, like, lighting bands, like, on the weapons and monsters and everything. Like, there's actual, like, hard lines that, you know, like, you know, across this line, it's very bright, and then once you pass this line, it's slightly darker, and then once you pass this other line, it's a little darker. Like, that's actual cel shading. You know, it's like cartoon shading.
The detail is great.
Yeah, we've really, you know, we're a team of perfectionists. You know, I'm definitely one. Our new animator who he blows me out of the water in that regard. You know, it's like if there's like one blemish on like anything I have in the game, he's like, I'll put it in the build, and like I just get a message from him, just like he just like totally locks in like on that one thing, like I noticed the alignment of this texture is slightly off, you know. It's just like, oh god, all right, I'll fix it. It's like, yeah, I spent 20 hours on that, but all right, you know, one thing wrong with it.
So what's going on in chat these days?
Everyone's asking ridiculously stupid questions about running this on like a TI-98 calculator.
You know, if they're going to run Doom and Minecraft on that kind of thing, I mean, give us 10, 20 years, and hopefully someone will do that.
There you go. You'll become the next.
If it gets popular enough, I mean, just people will do all sorts of ambitious, wild things with it.
Because this is a workshop game, right? Steam Workshop?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Do you guys plan on doing any sort of multiplayer or anything? Or?
No, I mean, look, it's something I've wanted to do. Like, my previous, the thing I did before this was a multiplayer Doom source port called Skull Tag, which I think Brutal Doom is actually based off of. So I inadvertently unleashed that on the world. it's just like not feasible to do right now. Like, we have like a small team. Like, it's taken us 6 years just to do this game. So like. You know, if you're trying to do multiplayer on top of that, it's like, how fucking long is that going to be? But, you know, it's like, I wouldn't want us to, like, stretch ourselves too thin. Like, I would rather do, like, a really solid single-player experience and then make people want more. Instead of, like, giving them, like, a mediocre single-player and mediocre multiplayer, then people are like, oh, whatever, both suck. I'm not really jazzed about it.
Right. Yeah,
you don't really see a lot of single-player FPSs. I mean, they all have multiplayer is the draw.
Right.
I know they have, like, single player, but they're not. I've never heard anyone really talk about single player in Halo.
Right. And, you know, this wasn't the case back then, but, you know, in hindsight, I'm glad I decided to go this route, because, like, now it's like there's so many, like, free-to-play arena shooters popping up, and it's like, and like, because like those are like free to play, like, you know, it's like, then how do you charge for your game? It's like, this other game's free and you're charging money. Why should I buy this when I can go get that for free? You know, and well, like, that's a tough thing.
What's one of your favorite games that you play other than your own shit?
I have a huge Marvel vs. Capcom 3 player. Like, I love that game. I was big into Marvel 2 in the day, and, you know, then Marvel 3 came out, and that's just, I don't think you could possibly top it, but it's so much better, and it's still so good.
So that's your jam, huh?
Yeah, but, I mean, for people who don't know, it's Marvel versus Cap, you know, Marvel, you know, comics and everything, you know, versus like Capcom characters, and like a 3-on-3 fighting game. So it's very colorful and just very vibrant. Anyway, and just the gameplay is just absolutely fast and furious. And, you know, that's honestly been a big influence in this game. In that game, like when you get combos, like it'll be like great, good, awesome. The higher ones are references to, like, Marvel comics and the Capcom games, you know. So you get like a combo of like 20, and it's like beautiful, you know.
Okay.
Beautiful Joe. Hey, you know, like combo of 40, and it's like galactic, you know, referencing Galactus. So we kind of decided to do the same kind of thing in this. So like the chain ranks, you know, which display on the left side, Like, the higher ones there are comic references. So you get, like, fantastic, marvelous, incredible, that kind of thing. And then the combos, which display on the right side, those higher ones are classic shooter references. So, you know, you'll get a combo that's, like, unreal, serious, ultra-violent.
Nice.
So... It kind of our little way of you know, paying some homage to some of the genres and things that have inspired this.
I hate to use the phrase because I just tweeted out that I hate this phrase the other day, but it seems apt. So it's basically a love letter to the genre.
God, I hate that phrase. But it's actually a love letter to multiple genres. See, I think most people, like, when they see this game, especially like when they haven't, you know, played too much of it, they're just like, oh, okay, Doom. And it's like, yeah, I mean, I'm not disputing it. I mean, that's certainly one of the big influences. But, you know, then, you know, like fighting games, arcade games, mostly like kind of like platformer, like console games, like Castlevania and Contra and Mega Man have actually been a huge influence in this game.
Yeah, I can definitely see the Contra and like the boss fights and stuff.
Yeah. And it was great, like at SGC, which is like the Screwtech game convention back in July. Like the guest of honor there was Keiji Inafune, and you know, so I mean, we're just sitting there like in the indie room, like not really expecting, you know, him to be walking around or anything. But I just look, and there he is, just, you know, checking out the game, and it's just like, oh my god. You know, and he like took pictures of the setup and everything, and you know, he kind of told us through his translator that, you know, it reminded him of like a first-person Mega Man game, which is awesome because it's actually totally true. Like early, like when we were first trying to kind of figure out what to call this game, like, yeah, I mean, the term I liked was a first-person platformer. But I never meant, like, platforming as in, like, jumping from platform to platform. I just mean, like, a first-person, like, Contra game. Or, like, a first-person Mega Man game. Because, yeah, it's like there's bosses which have, like, very patterned attacks. Like, very similar to, like, what you have in, like, a Contra or Castlevania. It's like every level you go to, it's like a different and unique environment, like, with its own mechanics. Like, the level you're on now, this is, like, the nukage, the sewage area. So, you know, you have like lava and like acid floors and those toxic barrels. So it's like within this level, like you just try and like have as much fun with like that motif as much as you can.
Right.
And like the level after this, you know, that's like the recycling center. So like there's conveyor belts and smashing walls and ceilings, and you just try and, you know, take that central concept and, you know, have as much fun with it as you can. You know, but it's like a Mega Man game, or like, you know, let's just go with Contra. You know, it's like the first level of Contra. It's like the jungle. And so, you know, so you kind of play with that concept. You know, actually, never mind. Mega Man's a better example for this. it's like you'll have, like, the ice level, you know, where it's, like, the end, it's, like, an ice boss. And, like, all throughout, you know, it's, like, you know, it's, like, sliding, you know, floors. You can slide on
right,
icicles
yeah, yeah.
and that kind of thing. You know, and then there will be, like, the, what's another example? Like a water level where it's, like, there's water you swim in, or like maybe you're in like a water vehicle of some sort.
And you
sort.
Move like slower, and it affects like the projectile movement and stuff.
Right,
like
right.
Yeah.
But you know, like I feel like that's such like a great, great like idea, like way to do things. Cause like it's such a great way to like change up the gameplay every couple levels to, you know, kind of keep things fresh. You know, or is like, you know, I don't want to throw it under the bus, but I mean, you know, it's whatever. It's a big boy; you can take it. But like something like Borderlands, like it's just like the same thing all throughout the game. It's like one environment, the wastelands. Like that's it. You know, and whereas, you know, and I don't know. It's like I just feel like it's much better to just mix things up.
No, I agree. I love the idea of Borderlands, but yeah, playing it. Sometimes becomes a chore.
Right.
Because it is very repetitive. It's just like loot, 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 loot.
Right.
But there's
you know, I understand that, you know, I mean, there, you know, there, that's, that is appealing to a lot of people. You know, it's yeah, it's at a, I don't know. But I mean, I'm just not one of them. And again, that's, you know, we're kind of getting back to the whole, you know, chunky versus regular pasta sauce kind of thing.
Good, you know, old chunky.
Different strokes for different folks. You know, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, I mean, you got to get some sauce on your rigatonis. Not everybody likes the same kind of sauce.
That's right, that's right. So. Hell, not everyone likes rigatoni, so.
Hey,
those
now.
Those people are heretics.
Yeah, but.
Well, I agree.
Who doesn't like pasta? Really?
I'm with you there.
Like, pasta is amazing. I'm pretty sure if aliens came to Earth, the first thing that they would do is they'd be like, hey, so yeah, we wanted you to know you're not alone in the universe and all that jazz, and you think we could get some spaghetti carbonara? It looks pretty bomb.
Like, hey, listen, we got a long trip back to Rigel 7. You think, like, we could have some to-go pasta? Like,
yeah, we got a carbo load.
You know, some of those raviolis or even gnocchis that would work. I'm down. Some angel hair. You know, anything.
Tuffles is saying chunky peanut butter is the best peanut butter. If you disagree, you're going to heaven. Don't you mean you're going to hell if you disagree?
I don't know about chunky peanut butter.
Oh man, I'm super hungry now.
this is not this stream is not doing good things for our hunger levels.
Somebody earlier,
like, I watched one like fighting game stream. It was like a round table. It was like they spent the first like hour and a half like ranking fast food places. And it's just like, how am I supposed to get through this stream without going to like Arby's or something afterwards?
Everybody knows that number one is In-N-Out.
Yeah, yeah. But, well, there was actually someone there who was like, I don't understand how In-N-Out is food. I'm just like, you're a terrorist.
What? Oh my god.
Damn, Al-Qaeda, that's like, asshole.
That's like the most blasphemous thing I've ever heard. Like, okay, like Steve, I'm so jealous that you live in, like, L.A. Like, I used to live out there, and, like, oh my god.
The food, I know.
I'm missing it out, god damn it.
It's just food apocalypse, dude.
It's like, I go to QuakeCon now, like, just because, like, there's an In-N-Out in Dallas.
Uh-huh.
Fuck promoting the game, I just want a juicy burger.
They're like, hey, can I get a comment from you about... No, shut up, I'm 4x4, I'll see you later.
People in Tucson, before we got In-N-Out, used to regularly make trips up to Phoenix just to get In-N-Out. Like, you'd go up there, you'd get your burger, and you'd turn around.
God, those are good people. Hey, how far is that? What kind of drive
is it? It's only about 2 hours, but it's a four-hour trip, you know, just to get
to Phoenix. Yeah.
So... Yeah.
See, Dallas is like a good 3 or 4, so that's like just out of range for me to do that.
Oh yeah, for sure.
That's
like, go there, get a hotel.
You just order like 6 number 2s.
Yeah.
Like, oh, animal fries.
Just go take a meat nap after you're done.
I know about Checkers. Like, I haven't had that like since I was like a kid. So like,
what the
I don't
fuck
even
is
like
Checkers.
I think it's like an East Coast thing. Like, I seem to remember it in like Florida, like when visiting my grandparents.
Is that like Chubby Checkers?
Maybe. It does seem a little like 50s themed. I don't know if they've like rebranded it since or anything. I don't know. But
yeah, because wasn't Chubby Checkers like a restaurant chain in the 50s or something?
It could have been. I wasn't around, so...
Yeah, it was like, you know, the Singer's restaurant chain where he went to get chubbier. Right?
Well, if they would just call, you know, that place Chubby's, I mean, that would be truth in advertising. that's another place I miss in California. Fatburger, that's another place that's truth in advertising.
Fatburger's okay, they're just expensive.
Really?
Yeah, it's like $8 for a burger.
Wow.
That's like this place, Zin Burger, here in town. It's like $10 for just a burger. No fries, no drink, no nothing.
That's stupid.
Yeah.
Those people should be arrested.
They're good burgers, though, but they're not.
No, they're not.
$10?
$10, I don't care.
See, all this talk of expensive food, like, you guys reminded me of Five Guys. Like, I can I get out of there for, like, less than, like, $13.
Yeah, and I'm not a big fan.
Yeah, I really think it's pretty overrated. It's good, but it's not like god tier like people make it out to be.
No. Yeah. I'd rather go to In-N-Out personally than Five Guys.
And by the way, the guy who said like In-N-Out is In-N-Out isn't even food. God, he's like an East Coast guy who thinks Five Guys is like the best thing ever. So.
I feel so left. There's fucking nowhere around here to go because I live by Pittsburgh. We don't even have a fucking Sonics here.
Really?
Yeah.
you're missing out. Sonics pretty good.
There's no Five Guys. There's no In-N-Out. No Jack in the Box. No nothing. There's not even an IHOP.
How do you live?
Yeah, man.
Chinese food and pizza.
Oh, I bet you guys have some awesome pizza.
See, like, I'm in Houston. Like, Sonic is like the default building.
I think that 90% of buildings are Sonic. Pittsburgh, but not around where I am.
I don't understand Sonic. It's like you drive there, and then you have to like push a button, and then somebody comes, and then I'm just like, dude.
Yeah, and like sometimes they do it on roller skates because fuck waiting another 5 seconds.
Well, yeah. It's like a throwback to the
have you guys ever seen one of the Sonic people eat shit while they're rollering their food?
I have not.
Oh man, that's unfortunate. I wanted to hear a story.
That would be a bucket list thing though. I could die now, I've seen that.
Just chili fries and shame everywhere.
We have IHOP here. I don't know where they don't have IHOP. How can there be a place that doesn't have IHOP? It's international!
Yeah,
that's true.
It's not the one fucking location house.
This is, like, fucking nothing around here. There's, like, the garbage tier sort of, like, McDonald's and Burger King and stuff, but...
Do you live in, like, a podunk town?
Have you ever seen the movie Slapshot?
Yes.
I live in that town. I literally live in the town that they filmed Slapshot in.
Oh, shit. Okay.
if Norway doesn't have IHOP, then Norway is not international. It's I don't know, it's like its own planet or something.
That should be the designation on whether or not you can join the UN. Do you have a fucking IHOP there? No? Okay, well, come back next time.
You're not really a nation, then, are you?
Yeah.
Is your town one of those towns that, like, commemorates the fact that Slapshot was shot there for forever? Like, is there a bar called Slapshots?
They did change the name of the hockey team to the Chiefs.
I love that. Hold on. Is there a bar called Slapshot?
No.
That was good.
Just with memorabilia all over the walls.
I totally see a team just like totally just...
just what's funny...
Well, this is our one claim to fame. Milk it for all it's worth, people.
It's such a shitty town that the Chiefs left.
Oh, like, but we paid you such honor.
Yeah.
We gave you our bar.
Shots.
No, there's not even like that.
Dude, if you want to make a bunch of money, bar called Slapshots.
Go open Slapshots right now.
Or All the Right Moves.
All the Right Moves. That's good. I like
I agree. Like if the town of Buffalo, like if every food product there isn't made of Buffalo, that's wrong.
Right. Yeah.
Buffalo is delicious, by the way.
It is.
Have you guys ever had a buffalo burger?
I have.
I have, yeah.
That's so juicy and glorious.
You know, the fact that they're so tasty, like, that's going to save them from extinction.
Yes.
I'm like, not even joking about that. Because, I mean, if animals that are tasty, I mean, we breed a lot of, it's like the cow population is, like, ridiculous.
Gotta get them ribbed.
Cows are not going anywhere.
Yeah, that's true.
Whereas the bald eagle, no one eats the bald eagle. You know, maybe if that bird was tastier, there'd be more of them.
Well, the other thing is, there are there's a dramatic rise in the number of bald eagles, and I think that that's because they're fucking terrifying. And, like, I don't know. I don't think I could ever fuck with a bald eagle without fearing for all of my lives.
Yeah, I have a healthy fear and respect for birds.
Yeah.
It's like, have you guys, like, been to, like, one of those, like, Renaissance fairs?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, and like they usually have like the falconer there.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they always tell you about like how fucking terrifying those birds are.
He's just
like, it's like, yeah, I can spot you from 4 miles in the air and sweep down and drill through your skull and like. And its talons can pier, you know, like rip through a block of steel. It's just like, God damn.
Flying torture machines.
He's like, and. He also knows basic HTML and all your Gmail passwords. Fuck.
Yeah.
He actually just hacked your Android smartphone right now.
That's like the Falcons of the future.
He's got a little Google Glass on his little falcon head.
In different ways.
My roommate's sitting in the other room, and every time I make a reference or a comment, he messages me on Steam. Like, we were just talking about buffaloes. He's like, there's buffalo in the sauce I made. I just sent him the link to the stream.
He's way totally... to contribute, guy.
Yeah, for sure.
Man. Yeah, I want us to make Falcon Glass now, like Google Glass, but for falcons. And that way they can just
that's
do
what
all
we need,
that.
Steve,
that's like
Falcons.
Army terrorists.
Why, like, why don't
you know,
them,
you
like,
know the sword this
too.
Shark needs? A bazooka.
If sharks had legs and bazookas, we'd be living in space.
No, we wouldn't be living at all. We'd
just be extinct.
Yeah. That's peace of humanity.
Hey, that gives me an idea for a gun for the game. Let's make a shark-zooka.
It shoots sharks at people.
Sharks that explode other sharks.
It's like a cluster
shark shrapnel?
Yeah, like,
yeah, it blows up into little sharks and then explodes.
Yeah, exactly.
That's... I now know what... From now on, when I have nightmares, that's what it'll be.
Like, hey man, this is a Steam Workshop game, I guarantee you. Guarantee this is coming.
Shark-zooka time.
Shark-zooka.
The cluster shark-zooka. That's the premium
it's
game
like
of the year.
It's like sharks combined with like the abilities of Cell.
Oh man, have you seen DBZ Abridged?
Yeah, oh god, it is fucking amazing.
It's hilarious.
I think if a shark told me that it wasn't in its final form, I would just shit my pants right there.
Just your brain aneurysm.
Your mind would just literally explode. Just
I don't want to know. What, do you get more teeth?
Yeah, seriously, like if I like found like the best artist of Earth, and I was like, okay, now draw a shark in its final form. Like they just be like, they just give me a picture of a shark.
Yeah.
Like here's my badass regular fucking shark drawing.
I'm pretty sure that these missiles with teeth.
Katanas for fins or something.
Oh man.
Make shark glass. Dude, sharks are ridiculous though. They are literally like aquatic missiles with teeth.
It's like they haven't undergone like any evolution like the past 500 million years because like fuck it, we're perfect. We don't need to change.
Evolution's like you think you might no, we're good.
Somebody needs to get on the shark's Wikipedia page and change the description to aquatic missiles with teeth. Somebody needs to do that shit like right the fuck now.
The aquatic missile with teeth, or shark.
In its natural habitat, or your gut. Oh my god, I'm dying so hard.
In its natural habitat, your nightmares.
Yeah. I was surfing in Corona Del Mar like a long time ago, and much younger, and like sharks would definitely like swim through the water a kinds of shit. But it's funny because the thing that actually screwed my life up the most while surfing was a fucking stingray, of all things. And I got nailed right in the calf muscle by one of those bastards. Yeah, so I grabbed it, and this is a true story. I'm sorry for anybody that's an animal person out there. I was so mad that I started smacking this stingray, like, against this piece of coral, because I was all pissed off at it for stinging me. And the lifeguard came running out, and he's like, "What are you doing, man?" And I point to, you know, the big gaping wound in my calf, and he goes, "Oh, well, those things are a protected species. You can't exactly be smashing them against rocks."
It was him or me.
Yeah, I would be like, "Hey, you know who else is a, you know what else is a protected species? Man."
Like, yeah,
I'm not gonna end up Steve Tom Irwin here.
Right. Yeah,
oh, what? Too soon?
Hey, well, at least, you know, he taught us a lesson. He taught us don't fuck with stingrays.
You know,
his death was not in vain.
He had so many opportunities, though, where he could have, I don't know, been reined in. Like, his whole thing was basically being inside of an animal,
yeah,
like, on camera.
Right, like, he just tempted fate his whole fucking career.
It's so many times, yeah. And I was reading this report. This was like a year or two after all that. And they were saying that there were so many times where he should have been fined, I guess, for violations, like with animals or for getting too close to protected species. And he wasn't, because of, in large part, like his celebrity status. And they were saying, like, it might have played a role in, like, what happened in the fact that,
oh, wow,
he didn't kind of have, like, a sense of, like, barriers or repercussions, because nobody would ever enforce them.
And by the way, the section you're in, you want to head back to the beginning?
All the way to the beginning of the level?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, on the way there, you'll hit the checkpoint. You'll see where to go.
Is there a map function in this game?
But yeah, I mean, wow, that's pretty interesting.
Is there a map, Eric said?
There is not a map. Okay. It's pretty difficult to pull that off in a 3D environment because a map is 2D and 3D is 3D.
I just get fucking lost. Like, yeah. I'm not faulting you for that. I understand. It's just I've gotten lost in my own hometown.
Right. Right. Yeah.
I always had that problem with Doom where I'd get lost in the levels, but I always refused to use the map because it always looked so fucking terrible, so I don't blame you for not having a map either.
Yeah, it's. I mean, in a way, I kind of think it's good because then that means, like, we have to... Yeah, again, like, you're streaming, so it's, you know... Well, hopefully things would go better normally in this
regard. I really am just this stupid. So, you know, it's okay.
Alright, anyway.
Nobody's gonna debate you there.
To design the maps.
No, like, not the lava! Damn it to hell!
Did you die again?
Oh
my god.
Death in 30, 29, 28, 27.
Steve, you're like Mr. Fantastic and the lava is Dr. Doom.
Oh man. So, Brad, I'm going to ask you a quick, cool question. Do you think that anybody watching out there might be lucky enough to get a Wrack key?
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's see if we can throw a key out there for some of
Sure.
You know who wants a Wrack key?
Who wants a Wrack key, AJ?
AJ does!
Wants a Wrack key, comma, AJ.
Oh, AJ.
No, but I'm definitely going to buy this game. It's
awesome.
It is. It's 10% off right now.
Hear that, people?
If you are interested in this game and for whatever reason you were unlucky enough to get a key, I do have some 25% off coupons I can give out.
Ooh, look at that, people. He's trying to hook you guys up with all kinds of deals.
Yeah.
V-Lab's coming through.
You guys are kind enough to come listen to us banter and check out this game and everything, so at least I can do.
Yeah, and sorry I suck so much at it, everybody.
No. No, yeah, like, honestly, Steve, this is pretty typical. or typical is even, well, I don't want to say even worse, but you know what I mean.
Nah, I get you. But no, I am not doing as well as I thought. And after AJ broke my spirits by telling me that I actually suck at Titanfall. That crushed me.
1v1 me, noob. God.
you don't actually
I would
suck
if you ever
this,
played.
So. There, and now you have your spirits back.
No, God. I don't have hard drive space for that.
No, like, I mean, we brought this game to, like, QuakeCon and, you know, various conventions. Because, I mean, it's, like, we would do that a lot, like, just to test it out. Most people would, like, not get past the first level. You know, well, I mean, second, if they're, like, they would, like, maybe get to the third. So
that's kind of the point, though, isn't it? Like, it's not supposed to hold your hand as much as current generation games, so...
We try and give you all the tools to deal with every kind of situation, and then we kind of try and introduce, like, every situation, like, in a sterile environment. Like, first, it's, like, the first time you see, like, those big, giant robots, which, like, slam the ground when you shoot them with a shotgun. Like, the first time you see them, like, they're just in a room by themselves.
Right.
So it's like you kind of get a chance to, you know, like kind of get your bearings against them.
And then you have to
So that way it's like you can kind of figure out what they're all about and how they work and everything. And like later on, like when you fight with like another group of monsters and like you forget what you learned and, you know, they attack them the wrong way or whatever. It's like, well, that's, you know, that's we want everything to like be, we don't want to cheat you. Like if something goes wrong, like we want it to be your fault.
Right. No, that makes sense. I mean, games like I Want to Be the Guy, where they totally cheat you and fucking kill you for no reason. I mean, that's fun every once in a while, but fair games are definitely
right.
Where it's at.
Yeah. And like, we want this to be like difficult but fair.
Yeah, no, that's the way to do it for sure. Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's, you know, I mean, there are some people who are like, oh, lies, what an archaic mechanic, ugh. But it's, I actually think it works, like, really well in this, because it makes death not being such a hard, harsh penalty.
Right,
yeah, I agree with that. Because I've been dying like a motherfucker on here.
See, like, imagine if, like, every death you got, like, you went all the way back to the beginning, unless you were, like, mashing quicksave. Then you'd be save scumming, and that's not any good.
No, I hate save scumming.
I haven't been paying attention to this specific detail, but whenever you run out of lives, do you lose all your guns?
No, you keep your guns once you go back to the beginning.
That's awesome. That always drove me nuts.
Yeah, so it's like even like a game over isn't really like a game over.
Right.
So...
That's cool. Like, whenever I used to die in Doom on, like, the last level, like, what the fuck are you supposed to do?
You know? Right, yeah. Right. And see, like, another reason, like, I feel like the life system is great is because, like, you don't have to, like, be worried about, like, oh, I killed two monsters, do I need to save it? Now, you know, it's like you can just sit back and play and not, like, constantly be worrying about saving.
Right.
It just frees you up to, like, just fully focus on the game.
Yeah, for sure. It's a cool idea.
Quick save is, like, still there, but, like, if you're playing on... Like, if you're playing on casual, then it works in, like, the traditional sense. But, like, if you're playing on, like a higher difficulty level, like, quick saving will, like, return you to the menu, and then it's erased once you restore it. And that's so it's, like... All it is like, preserving, like, your status. Like, if you have to leave or something...
Yeah. No, that makes sense.
So,
well, I'm gonna take a break here, and then let's help some people out with some coupons or keys, or we'll just tell them all to fuck off. Whatever we're doing, let's do it.
If you tell people to fuck off, I want to be the one to do it.
But you do that all the time.
Yeah, you're really too
hobby.
Good at it.
I'm really good at it.
Everybody else, we need some practice, man. You can't take this away from us.
Everyone has something there. Okay.
Everyone contributes something, and that's Eric's contribution.
Right.
Yeah, that's what I bring to the table, telling people to go fuck themselves.
It's like his superpower.
That's a great superpower.
That would I'm going to call myself Go Fuck Yourself Man.
I think that those, like, earlier we were talking about if Phil Fish had a superpower, his superpower would be that he could control fish, but only in a Chinese food restaurant. So, like, those koi that you see in the big giant fish tank when you walk in, like, that's the fish that Phil Fish could control. But only those fish.
I wish Phil Fish could control his anger. Actually, no, I don't. Phil Fish is one of the most entertaining people of all time.
Like, what do you, why? Take that away from all of us?
Oh, man. People that guy's awesome.
Like, I don't know. Like, other developers had to, when I say that, like, sort of sympathize with him. And I'm like, yeah, but, you know, it's funny for me.
I did until, like, this latest incident. Like, he come back to Twitter and, like, he tweeted, like, 98 times per second about Ferguson. And then just, like, explodes in a rage and leaves. And it's like, you, like you know, and he totally, like, brought it on himself, too. It's like, okay, you know what? You
just, like,
there's no excuse this time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I can empathize with someone and still find their actions to be hilarious.
Right, right.
Oh, poor Phil. Poor Philippin. I don't even know.
I feel like Nickelodeon needs to make a show called Phil of the Fish. it's like about like an 8-year-old boy named Phil who lives in the sea.
He's just mad all the time.
it's like every season, like he rage quits Twitter, and then season premiere comes back.
Wow, timing! This just appeared on my wall. Let's see, what is this? Fuck off! Irritable owl syndrome.
That is one pissed off owl.
That is perfect timing.
But I don't think I've ever seen, like, a happy owl.
No.
Like, even the owl in Winnie the Pooh is, like, kind of pissed off.
He's kind of a dick, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's always preaching at everybody. Did anyone actually buy Polytron? You mean Fez?
I think he was selling the whole company.
Yeah, they were, yeah. He was selling Polytron. Or that's what he claimed on Twitter.
And then he'll come back with, like, Polygontron. Ah!
Okay.
Polygon.
And then he'll rage quit and sell that, too. And then rage quit Twitter again.
I think the funniest thing that he just keeps doing is he keeps canceling Fez. Like, he's canceled Fez, like, 6 times now. Oh, that's my favorite.
Fez 2, or...
Or, yeah, Fez 2, yeah. He just keeps canceling it.
I he may as well. I mean, I don't know. I can't see it being good. I don't know.
Well, the point I'm making is that nobody expected it to come out in the first place.
Oh.
And he keeps saying, like, every time somebody tweets something mean at him, he's like, you know what? Fucking Fez 2 is canceled. How do you like that? And it's like, nobody cares anymore, Phil. Nobody cares.
poor Phil. So yeah, let's help some people out with some cool stuff, and then maybe we should wrap it up. We've been doing this for 3 hours today.
Oh wow.
Yeah. So I think we're gonna throw some things out there for the folks for hanging out and chatting with us, and then let's call it a day, gentlemen.
Oh, Remy has a picture of a happy owl. Aw, that's adorable.
That owl is happy as fuck, man.
Aww.
It is a baby owl, though.
Yeah, it hasn't had time to get, like, pissed off yet.
Right, yeah.
Become disenchanted with the world.
Maybe that's the problem. Owls are just jaded.
it's like all owls, like, just... Once they reach adulthood, like, they just become, like, 40-year-old hipsters. Like.
All right, everybody. So I'm going to throw a tweet out there.
Fez 3 confirmed.
Wow.
We're about to do something awesome. All right, Brad, do you want to take the reins? What do you want to? How do you want to do something here?
I'll. Why don't we start with a key?
Okay.
Just a free key for it. Do you have like some kind of giveaway system or?
No, not really.
Okay.
we could take out one of the characters and let these guys try to figure it out.
Okay. All right. Let's see here.
We'll pop it on Twitter. Or no. We'll throw it in the stream. This is for the streamy stream.
Yeah, I'll put it in the stream.
Okay.
All right. Let's see. Am I still logged into Twitch? I am. Okay, there we go. The missing character is the first letter of Mega Man's little buddy in Mega Man X.
Ooh, there you go, everybody.
Because we were talking about Mega Man earlier.
Ah.
Yeah, see what I did there?
Yeah. Anyone quick enough to figure that out?
What's awesome is like they've all been just staring at the key for like 45 seconds to hear what the clue is.
Right. I forgot about the delay.
So they're like, oh fuck, A, no fuck, B, fuck, C.
Anybody get it?
I got it. I'm just kidding.
AJ really wanted it.
Nah, I won't do that to our streamy buddies. No. Twitch delay OP, please nerf.
Rumor is they're whining about Intel pulling it. Oh, yeah. We're talking about giving away keys right now.
Yeah.
Hey guys.
Yeah. The Gamergate stuff is later.
What are your tweeterers?
Let's post our tweeters.
I am this.
I am at Zombie Jesus with three O's.
I'm Famicom. Remy, you already follow me on Twitter.
Free cheese? No. There's no
too many there. Activation attempts? Uh-oh.
I must not have filled that outright because I know you have more than one follower, AJ.
Oh. Yeah, I definitely do.
It's three O's.
Alright.
Is there a fake zombie Jesus?
There's one with two O's.
Ah.
There we go. That's much better.
Poser.
You should be that guy,
right? Up.
Like, buy out his account?
No, just beat him up.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Somebody said too many activation attempts. What does that mean?
I have no idea.
You guys exploded the key.
Good job, assholes. Jeez. No, did someone get that? Otherwise, I'll put another one in there.
I think someone may have grabbed it. We're not sure.
I would imagine because like if you're trying to put something in, like how would it know like if you? I just don't see how the system would work.
Mr. Popo 666. Oh, good God. Oh, that's terrifying.
Mr. Popo. I like Mr. Popo a lot in DBZ Abridged.
He's very scary.
Well, only the blue version, right? Because that one, that's the one that isn't offensive.
Oh, right, yeah. Because he's... Oh, yeah, they did make him blue.
Yeah.
Ball Z. I forgot about that.
Yeah. Which, now it's just offensive to blue people, so I don't know what they're thinking.
With that? That's really insensitive to blue people.
I know.
Like a Twitter smurf
poor,
hashtag.
Poor blue man gloop. Group. Gloop.
That's a branded product that they're going to sell. It's a facial cream. Blue man gloop.
Hey, so how about this? Like, if anyone wants a 25%... Oh, go ahead.
Oh, no, I didn't mean to interrupt you. You go. I was just making a dumb joke.
Oh, sorry.
I stumbled
over it. But if anyone wants a 25% off coupon, just hit me up on Twitter. I am at FBE Carnival. I posted it there in the chat. I'll post it again. It scrolled up slightly.
I'm hitting you up right now.
Sweet.
AJ wants in on that coupon status.
I do.
Yes. Sure.
There you go, people. Yep. Hit them up on Twitter. Get some coupons. Buy the game.
We were going to print out all those and put all those coupon codes and put them on cards and like put them on all the seats at QuakeCon.
That sounds like a lot of work.
It was going to be like $4,000 or something.
Holy shit.
Holy shit.
Yeah! Fuck that. We'll just give them out. So.
Yeah, that's... No.
So, yeah, I mean, I got plenty, so. As many as you guys want.
Cool, man. Thanks for hooking someone up with a key, hooking everyone up with some coupons.
Yeah, no problem.
Hell yeah. We'll,
And thank you for streaming the game and checking it out and everything.
Oh, no, for sure. I wish we could have gotten more people in here. You know, it's funny. I feel like everybody just wants to talk. I'm like, well, yeah, but... Let's play some video games again, everybody.
That is what, the whole industry, the whole us as gamers is supposed to be about, right?
Yeah, so that's what we've been doing. I mean, we're still more than happy to talk about shit.
Yeah.
But and if you go back into our previous videos, you'll see our Pixel Fireplace fireside chat that we had. Where we had some pixelated hot dogs and marshmallows that we were roasting.
That's awesome.
It was pretty
good. Oh, yeah, don't forget, the marshmallow is now the leader of Gamergate.
Oh, we determined that. Yeah.
Also, the marshmallow already got banned from Twitter.
Really?
Yeah, did it really?
Someone said that in chat earlier.
Are you serious? How did the marshmallow get banned from Twitter? Come on.
He said, like, unsolicited at mentions.
What?
Which I didn't even know was a thing.
What has there ever been... Yeah. What has there ever been a solicited at mention?
Yeah, I might get in trouble for all the shit that I gave the Mary Sue for writing an article about Family Guy.
That's so dumb. So they already shut down our leader?
Yeah.
How could
Scandal.
Dude, that's it. Now... It's on. I wasn't fired up about anything before, but when you take down the marshmallow, you take down all of us. Like, united, we stand as long as it's a giant marshmallow that we're standing for. We should just make the Stay Puffed Marshmallow Man our mascot.
You can't take that thing down. You need the fucking Ghostbusters for that. Like, they're not around.
Alright, guys.
Rogue just...
I see him. He's typing in the chat. What does he do? Operation Wolf Blitzerkrieg?
Yeah, a bunch of people are tweeting at CNN right now.
Yeah, apparently, like, the thing is, like, Gama Sutra's, like, trying to get CNN to run a story about how bad Intel is or something.
Oh, really?
What?
Yeah, or how they were pressured by misogynists or something.
No, they were pressured by a marshmallow.
Yeah, he's the leader. A friendly marshmallow and an angry owl, apparently.
That's why they took him off of Twitter, because they knew that he was the threat to their oligarchy.
Was the marshmallow slightly critical of Anita Sarkeesian?
No. I think what it was that the marshmallow dared to say that sugary treats are only best when they're slightly caramelized over an open fire. And that
is... Okay, now I agree. He needs to be taken out.
Ban him.
Blasphemous. Just,
silence that marshmallow. Now.
I can't handle his gooey truth.
We were saying that the marshmallow is a microcosm analogy for the state of the gaming industry. It tries to appear toasty and warm and friendly on the outside, but inside it's just pasty white.
But seeing it now the marshmallow has become a martyr, and now it will galvanize the graham cracker and Hershey's chocolate bar.
Isn't the graham cracker the false shepherd of the marshmallow?
Oh, God.
We're, okay, yeah, this is getting way too existential and philosophical about s'more components.
It is.
So anyways, guys, thank you so much, all of you, for hanging out today. Thank you so much for all of our viewers for tuning in. Thank you so much for everyone on Twitter for interacting. Thanks to the people who contributed. Somebody gave us a copy of Shadow of Mordor to review. That was amazing.
Awesome.
I know, it was really dope.
That's actually better than Wrack, because that's like $50, and this is only 13. God, I'm an asshole now. I didn't
know. So, I just want to thank everyone for all your participation, and it was really fun. Hopefully we'll do more of these more consistently, especially now that I'm back in a regular city, so...
Thanks for having me on, Steve.
Yeah, thank you so much, Eric, for stopping by. AJ, you said.
No, yeah, thanks.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, thanks for hanging out, everybody. We appreciate it.
Thank you, AJ. You're the best. I appreciate you streaming Shadows of Mordor.
You can go fuck your face.
All right, everybody. Enjoy the night.